Hello, I'm the Media Whiz, because one art form wasn't enough. Isn't being a fan of something great?
It's something that's always been said before, but no matter what something is, it'll always have its fan base. And it's always great to see people show tribute to the things that they love, whether it be through videos, artwork, or blog posts.
With that said, there are a bunch of lunatics and fanbases, no matter what fanbase you're a part of, that make your fanbase look worse for wear. With that said, this video was made to showcase the three phases that crazy fans and fanbases go through. Let's start with phase one, ignorance.
Everything you know is wrong, black is white up.
Yes, ignorance. This phase shows the kind of fans who refuse to listen to anyone's opinion, even if it's just slightly different. And when I say refuse, I mean that they will deny and not even take anything that you're saying into consideration. The kind of people who are like,
Disney's movies are not as good as they used to be. I mean, seriously, Frozen, Big Hero 6, why can't Disney go back to making good movies like Aladdin or The Lion King or Little Mermaid? Gosh, I'm so angry at Disney right now for not making good movies like they used to back in the 90s.
Or like, dude, I don't see why everybody hates Transformers 2. I mean, yeah, it doesn't have really good plot or characters or anything like that, but hey, it had hot chicks and stuff exploding, dog. Then you get to phase 2, obsession.
Give it to my lead. Say this guy's a fan of Ninja Turtles. He has all the movies, shows, games, comics, all the toys from when he was a kid. Yeah, he really loves TMNT. So what stops this guy from being full-blown insane? If he's willing to admit that the TMNT franchise has flaws. If he's willing to see that the flaws in something that he likes and has usual common sense, then he'll be all good.
But let's show some examples of fans and fanbases that have taken their obsessions all the way over to the deep end.
This one brony on Facebook said that he was going to run away from home, saying that he hopes his dad wouldn't notice, so that he can marry Twilight Sparkle. These Steven Universe fans openly harassed and threatened the girl for drawing Rose as skinnier than she usually is in the show. A Knothole resident,
God, now I feel ancient for pulling this video out,
complained about Sonic 4 not being a real Sonic sequel since Sonic's eyes are green instead of black.
I, along with most people in their late 20s, was expecting the classic style black-eyed Sonic. This is Sonic! This is the classic Sonic! I bought this plushie in 1994! Look! Beady black eyes!
And lastly, we got Smike, who for the longest time made top 10 lists about Five Nights at Freddy's. And look, there's nothing wrong with being known for something. I mean, look at Markiplier with Five Nights at Freddy's, or Josh the Fiery Joker with My Little Pony. The thing is, they don't just do those kind of videos and that's it. Mark does way more than just FNAF Let's Plays, and Josh does more than just MLP reviews. They don't constrict themselves to one thing that they're known for. For the longest time, though, Smike dedicated himself to nothing but FNAF top 10 lists, and to the point that even people have said that he's milking the FNAF franchise for money.
But I will give Smike a little bit of credit, since he's not really doing as much Five Nights at Freddy's videos as he used to do. Well, now we're at phase 3. We've had ignorance, obsession, but what happens when you combine the two? Then you get phase 3, being over-defensive. Now, I went around and asked a lot of my fellow online content producers what the worst kind of fan in a fanbase is, and a lot of us came to the same conclusion that over-defensive fans are easily some of the worst.
For example, take those console fanboys who like to have console debates. Not even sensible ones, the kind of console debates that come down to two guys going, my console's better than yours, nuh-uh, mine is.
PS3 make the best games.
Like Sony is, you know, I hated the Bluetooth, how it sounded. Everybody sounded like a drive-thru guy on the PS3. Apparently it sounds a lot like that on the PS4 as well. You know, I'm not into that. I like the clear party chat that the Xbox offers.
He's trying to say, like, Gears of War. Shit, fuck Gears of War. More like Tears of War. Man, that shit has that little bitch crying all the time. See that commercial?
You know, outside of that, it's like the whole smart match and reputation, the ability to appear offline. Xbox Live is really just a well-rounded, well-thought-out online service, and I really like it.
True Games has some 50 Cent in the background, some Fat Joe, some ballin'.
Or the Gravity Falls fans that keep going, ugh, Disney canceled my favorite show, it's all their fault. Even though the creator openly said himself that he wanted to end the show after the second season. Seriously, the comment sections are usually where you'll find these kind of people, whether the video be a rant.
But none of them are as unintelligent as some of the maniacal PewDiePie fans who truly believe he is a god who creates only the highest form of art.
A parody.
I'm not afraid to get really pissed, at all my critics, that hardly exist, I'm such a whiny baby.
Or a vlog video.
But I feel like, in a sense, Doug Walker and the Nostalgia Critic character is changing what he first intended for it, and that is kind of annoying.
These are the kind of fans that are so obsessed with the things that they love that they will blindly and ignorantly defend what they love to the very end, completely ignoring anyone else's opinion, even if it's just slightly different. And look, there's nothing wrong with having a debate with something that you love. No, these people aren't even here to have a debate. They're just here to say that you're wrong and that they love it so much and that anyone that dare criticizes the things that they like are awful people. Oh yeah, Wiz, as it turns out, all the fan bases that you ranted about, certain members of those fan bases want to have a word with you now. Just wanted to let you know. Yeah?
Wiz, I thought you were a brony. Come on, man, I thought we were bronies before Honeev.
Steven Universe is the greatest show ever. How dare you criticize such an amazing show like Steven Universe?
Gravity Falls is the best thing ever. Don't give any of the episodes a negative review.
Dude, why the hate, man?
You know, it really wasn't nice to talk about the scariest game ever.
I haven't seen the review yet, and I don't really know what you're gonna say, but no!
Look, guys, just because I used your fan bases as examples does not mean I hate you or any of the fan bases that I used, okay? I was just using them as examples to show what kind of crazy fans there really are in your fan bases.
So, you're saying that not all fans in the fan bases you talked about are bad?
Yes.
Okay. So is that it? Can we go about our day? Yeah? Feel kinda awkward now. Well, I guess I don't need these. Oops.
I'm the Media Whiz, because one art form wasn't enough.
Dear Slim, I wrote you, but you still ain't calling. I left my cell, my pager, and my home phone at the bottom. I sent two letters back in autumn, you must not have got them. There probably was a problem in the post office or something. Sometimes I scribble addresses too sloppy when I jot them. But anyways, fuck it, what's been up, man? How's your daughter? My girlfriend's pregnant too, I'm about to be a father. If I have a daughter, guess what I'ma call her? I'ma name her Bonnie. I read about your Uncle Ronnie too, I'm sorry. I had a friend kill himself over some bitch who didn't want him. I know you probably hear this every day, but I'm your biggest fan. I even got the underground shit that you did with Scam.
Now, time to do a Five Nights at Freddy's top 10 list about the cupcake. Number 10, it's delicious.
Dude, hey, unnecessary. I'm gonna drop the beat and you're gonna know that. Outtakes.